top of it. Well, this horse is the oldest equestrian statue in England, and it normally sits in Lumley Castle, way up on the wall, and it's been recently colored. The interesting thing is that it was collected by the greatest collector in Henry VIII, his ton, or Lumley, his arm. But by that time, people didn't wear armor. In other words, this is an effigy of the 200 years earlier. So even then, they were still in their hands. And this guy had portraits painted, even while I was furious, filling his castle to show how far back this is. And the English were fascinated by this whole idea of these here medieval roots, a sort of French chivalric tradition.
His taste, that it's like something from the antique.
it's so beautiful. There's mirrors and folds, and these rhythms, the way their heads turn, the interval and spacing, it's really great. Yeah, you can't see too well, but there are some fabulous things back there. You see the top one is the Doncaster Cup, which is another one of these gold cups, which was modeled after an antique vase, and it has extraordinary detail. It's by Paul Stewart, who is their great silversmith. And then one of my pets in it is just down the lower right. You get a coddled egg machine. We'll have to go up closer and take a look. But it was the way English breakfast was legendary. And they had these big country house weekends. People would come in and have breakfast. And you see this thing has four cups for eggs.
Oh, yes.
And then it has an hourglass, so you can have a room at that.
Mr. President, what do you want out of it?
What do you think of the exhibition? It's beautiful. Sir?
Yes.
Mr. President, what are you going to tell those Soviet journalists tomorrow? What message do you want them to take home? Thanks, Mr. Brown.
Yes.
Mr. President, what message do you want those Soviet journalists to take back in the Soviet Union?
Just whatever they've seen here.
This is cool one. This is one I'm really going to be showing you in the way it's because they have it. And it fits into its room so well. That's the only thing that goes this guy was the Prince of Wales in the 18th century. And his shooting constitution is going to take it over as the principal. And his guy's pal, the shooting whale, his cousin, and his pal, his name's Spencer. Probably the first Earl Spencer. So this is.
Why don't you come over here too?
Excuse me, let me get a hand.
No worries. George, why don't you try to keep going, man?
Yeah. No, we don't.
How did you like that picture?
Really loved it.
A lot of calls on it.
Don't go too far.
Get the other ring of the lights.
A lot of calls.
Come in, sir.
Enemies to government.
Yugoslavian problem out of state.
Well, we're anxious to hear what forthcoming steps there are now and what you're doing. Incidentally, I have just signed a directive to assist your public security forces in the fight against terrorism, and the training should start in about 30 days.
That's wonderful. That's the reason why I brought the colonel here, because he's in charge of the security, and he's doing a wonderful job in humanizing the whole process of security. And this is the strength of the humanizing and democratic
process. That's great.
So thank you very much for that. Yeah.